Welcome to my YouTube channel, which is titled Research Methods Class with Dr. Lydia Wabugo. In Research Methods, we have a book titled Research Methods, Theory and Practice. This book is accessible through the website where you can access the hard copy of the book or a downloadable PDF format of the book. In the same website, you are able to access all the courses, which includes the free research methods course, IBM SPSS statistics course, M&E consultancy course, which are available at a fee. Please find the links in the description. Welcome. Welcome to our lesson today, and we are going to start discussing references in social science research. That is why we are going to title our lessons as 1, 2, 3, and 4, because we will have various components of referencing that we are going to discuss. So today we are going to look at the differences between 6th edition of the APA and 7th edition of the APA. But before that, we have just concluded discussing chapter 5 of the research project thesis and dissertation. And we have said this now has concluded our whole document, which we now call the project thesis or dissertation. We started by looking at chapter 1, we have talked about chapter 2, we have talked about chapter 3, we have talked about chapter 4, and we have now looked at chapter 5. So from today, we will be discussing the APA style of referencing. So like we have mentioned, our lesson today will majorly identify the differences between APA 6th edition and APA 7th edition. There could be someone who is asking, you mean we have APA 7th edition? Yes. Another one could be asking, what is this APA that we are talking about? Now, APA means American Psychological Association, and it is a referencing style that is commonly used in social science researches. This style dictates how to reference in-text, what we call in-text citation, and even how to write our reference list at the end of our chapter 5 once we have completed writing the thesis project or dissertation. Now, APA is unique from other reference style because it uses the author date style for in-text citations. And when we talk about author date, it means the author's name and their year of publication, when they published the work. And there is always a comma after the name and after the date of publication. And we'll be looking at this in this lesson. APA introduced the 7th edition in October 2019, and by 2020, many institutions have started using it, and the 7th edition has replaced the 6th edition, which was published in 2009. What has necessitated this change from 6th to 7th? Of course, we have had many editions. If you are talking about 7th, then that tells you that there were many editions before. But the 7th edition has been necessitated by a lot of changes in the academic world, and notably is the use of the online materials and embracing the use of bias-free language in academic documents. So these two, plus many others, have necessitated the change or the revision of the 6th edition to incorporate those changes in the 7th edition. So we are now using the 7th edition in our referencing, not the 6th edition. So this lesson will look at the main differences between the 6th and the 7th edition. The first one is the font. I'm sure if you're writing your research project or thesis or proposal, you must have been told that we only use Times New Roman 12 point. That is what was accepted in the 6th edition. In the 7th edition, you can use Caribli 11 point, Arial 11 point, Lucida Sans Unicode 10 point, Times New Roman 12 point, and Georgia 11 point. So all those have been accepted now in the 7th edition. So you do not need to restrict your writing or your text to only Times New Roman. However, there needs to be consistency of the font. If you are using Georgia, then make sure that it is Georgia across the document and the point should be 11 as it is indicated in this difference. The other difference is the place of publication. Sixth edition required you to indicate where the work was published, the place of publication. Like you can see, that book was published in Nairobi, and we used to put a full colon after the place of publication. In the seventh edition, now you do not need to write the place of publication, so there are no colons, they are only full stop. So after the title of the book, then there should just be the publisher. And note that the title, even in the seventh edition, should be italicized. The title should be italicized. In the in-text referencing, the other difference, especially where you have multiple authors, the sixth edition required you to cite all the authors in the first mention or in the first citation, and then subsequently you use et al. For instance, this book that is written by Wabogo, Chalo, B, and Nyoje in 2015. In the sixth edition, in our first citation, we needed to write all the four others. And then subsequently, we use et al. Now, the seventh edition does not require the mention of all the others at the first instance. Even at the first instance, you just write Wabogo et al. And then show the year of publication. And note, there is a full stop after et al. And then comma showing the year of publication. List of references. In the sixth edition, when you are listing the references, the APA sixth edition required a mention of seven others. For instance, what is shown. And when you get to the sixth, you put the three dots, the ellipses, and then now show the last one who becomes the seventh one. In the seventh edition, you can list up to 20 others. You can list up to 20 others like it is shown. Website citations. In the sixth edition, when you retrieved a document from a website, you needed to write retrieved from, and then you show the URL. For instance, if this document was retrieved from the Commission for Higher Education website, then you needed to show retrieved from. But now, in the seventh edition, the website citations include the name of the website and you exclude retrieved from. So you can see we have Commission for Higher Education 2011. The title of the book, the work is Status of Universities in Kenya. And then the name of the website is the CUE or Commission for University Education. And then you show the website. So you don't need to write retrieved from, which was done in the sixth edition. And again, in the sixth edition, they were not including the name of the website. They were not including the name of the website. YouTube video in the reference. In the sixth edition, again, the YouTube needed to be referenced as follows. The uploader, the year, the month and day, and then title of the video, video file, and then retrieved from, then you show the URL, again, as it is shown. You see, an example of research methods class with Dr. Lydia Wabogo, 2021, video uploaded on March 26, which is definition of research characteristics and purpose. And then I put into brackets. The brackets should be the block one. Video file and then retrieved from, you give the link. In the seventh edition, you include the person or the organization that uploaded the work, the channel name, if it is different from their real name, the date it was uploaded, and then the video title, which is italicized, and then the word video in square brackets, the name of the site, and a link to the video. So you are not writing retrieved from. And again, you are including the name of the site. In this case, it is YouTube. And the title of the video title should be italicized. So you can see, I have not included the name because the name of this channel has the name of the author. So I did not want to have two names appearing with Wabogo L and then Research Methods Class with Dr. Lydia Wabogo. So you have the channel and then the date, the year, and the month when it was uploaded. You have the title of the video and it is italicized. And then the video in brackets. The name of the site is YouTube and then a link to that video. Now, if it is in text for the same YouTube video, sixth edition required you to write the name of the channel. So, for instance, you would say Research Methods Class with Dr. Lydia Wabogo 2021. Whereas in the seventh edition, you use whichever name appears first in the full citation. The name that appears first in our different six that we have just discussed, whether that's a real name or a channel name. So if I go back to number six, if this example I had started by writing Wabogo LN, then I write the name of the channel, then when I come to in-text, it will just be Wabogo 2021. The way I have started it in number six as Research Methods Class with Dr. Lydia Wabogo, that is what I would show in the in-text citation. Captions in the text. In the sixth edition, figures were numbered in the order they appeared, while tables were numbered as per the chapter number. And again, the figure title was written below the figure, while the title of the table was written above the table. Now, in the seventh edition, both figures and tables should be ordered in the order in which they appear. However, if your institution still insists that tables should be numbered as per the chapter number, then this should take precedence over the APA. And in the seventh edition, both their titles are written above the figure. Note now there is no one below and above, other one above like it was in the second edition. And when we are talking about a figure like it is shown, or even if it was a table, it should have a title which is directly below the figure number and above the figure itself. And the title is given in title case and it is in italics. For instance, figure one, then below that you write the title of the figure, which is italicized. Note now, in sixth edition, we were writing, for instance, figure one, then we put colon and we write the title. So now it will be figure one, then below figure one, we write the title and should be italicized and in title case. And this is both for figures and tables. That is how the two of them should be presented. Then language. In the sixth edition, the presentation of the work was very scientific. There was avoidance of the use of biased language that would show the issue of gender, age, disability, racial, ethnic identity, or sexual orientation. But now, the seventh edition allows us to use they or their, as they are endorsed as gender neutral pronoun in the seventh edition, something that was not there in the sixth edition. Again, the seventh edition also recommends using first person pronouns. You can use I when referencing to your own actions and reflections instead of the other, like it used to be in the sixth edition, which it was assumed that it would create ambiguity. Then it is important to note that just like in the sixth edition, entries in the reference list should still be ordered alphabetically, and they should have a hanging ident. And this will be shown in our next lesson. So that brings us to the end of our lesson, where we have looked at the differences between 6th and 7th edition, not all, but the notable differences that we need to take note of as we write our academic papers. So our next lesson will look at how we cite journals and books, books with single and multiple authors, and also online books. Do not forget to subscribe to this channel, like and share this lesson with your friends, and feel free to ask any question on the comment section.